Hello, GMAT Janta. Trick 26, 145 to 51, presented by Mission MBA. I hope you're enjoying the series and you have come so far, so you must have learned so many things. And I feel great about it, to be very honest. Today, we're going to talk about one brilliant GMAT trap for exponents. When you see the equation of the form x to the power fx equals to x to the power gx. Now, there is a special catch which comes over here. So are you ready? Let's go ahead and witness that. But before that, you know the drill. Press the bell icon so that you never miss an update and stay updated to most relevant GMAT questions and most relevant GMAT tricks. Alright people, we gave this question to 100 GMAT aspirants and 90 of them came out with the wrong answer. Even the ones who scored quant 48, 49, 50 came up with the wrong answer. This question looks simple, but it has a catch. It has a GMAT edge. If I ask you to solve this question, you might also get it wrong. Pause the video and try to get the answer. If you get the answer as 4, guys, you are one of those 90 kids who failed to solve this problem correctly. Let's see what you're missing. So, I need to find out the sum of all the solutions of this equation. Of course, the natural thing which comes to our mind is, the bases are same, so the powers need to be same. Let's solve them and get the x. Very simple. But, is it that simple? Of course not. Let's solve. 2x squared plus 4x minus 6 equals to x squared plus 8x plus 6. That ends up in x squared minus 4x. And minus 12 equals to 0. And that's nothing but x minus 6 and x plus 2. Yes, you can solve the quadratic equation in just one step. The next video will be on the same concept. But right now, I'm just solving it using the splitting middle term. Now, from here, I get the value of x as 6 and the value of x as minus 2. And the sum comes out to be 4. Most of you came up to this part and gave the answer as 4, but that's wrong. What you are missing, guys? Think, what if x becomes 1? Bases would become 1, and 1 to the power anything, even the powers are different. Let us say 11 and 13. The solution is still there. The value, the equation is still correct. So guys, 1 is definitely going to be the solution in such case. Because even the powers come different, the answer is still gonna be same, right? So that's the catch, and you need to be careful about it. So guys, the answer is not just 6. The answer is not just minus 2. The answer is also 1. Of course, and x is 0 as well. 0 to the power anything equals to 0 to the power anything, ultimately 0. But right now we're talking about sum of solutions, so 0 is not gonna impact. But what about minus 1? Minus 1 to the power even will become equal to minus 1 to the power even. Now, you again do not require the powers to be equal. You just require whether they become both even or both odd. Because in those scenarios, this will become minus 1 and this will become 1, hence equal. So, that is our responsibility to check minus 1 as well. That might be the solution and may not be the solution. Let's go ahead and check. Let's put x equals to minus 1. So this becomes minus 1 to the power 2 into minus 1 whole square. That's 2 minus 4 minus 6. And ultimately, minus 1 to the power I have is minus 8. That's ultimately even, right? Which will make it 1. Now, what happens to the second one? The second one becomes minus 1 to the power, that's 1 minus 8 plus 6. That's minus 1 to the power minus 1. That's an odd. So, will become minus 1. So, guys, minus 1 has to be rejected. So, what finally I have? 6 minus 2 and 1. That makes the sum 5, not 4. So, the correct answer, guys, is E, not D. I hope you got what mess you are creating when you miss 1. But in the real game, you are also going to check minus 1. And when it comes down to the number of solutions, remember 0 as well. Alright? So I hope you must have learned one GMAT trap today. So guys, so stay tuned and subscribe our channel so that you never miss update and stay tuned to beautiful question, beautiful GMAT traps, which are actually hurting your score. Let's get ready to make our score from quant 45 to 51. It's time to take the jump and show what you got.